Sony's new product launches include US Xperia smartphones and a smart band. Samsung's new tablet lineup is full of names, but also a really cool UI. And if you wanted a new Pebble, you've got a new Pebble. I'm Jaime Rivera, and I've got this Pebble first generation for sale for any of you interested. I want to buy my Pebble Steel. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let's start today off with some official news, as Sony has just unveiled three new products at CES focused on the United States market. First of all, we get the Sony Xperia Z1 Compact, which is pretty much the Z1 only in a smaller chassis, pretty much like the Z1F. And speaking of the Z1F, we do get the Z1S, but it's focused on T-Mobile, and for some reason it's made out of plastic, because apparently T-Mobile asked for it that way. But we also get this smart band, which is sort of like a Nike, you know, fitness band. It's focused on business mainly because Sony already makes a smartwatch, but hopefully we'll be getting these things in the Pocket Now Labs very soon to tell you how good they are or not. Now let's talk about Samsung, as the company has just announced four new tablets at CES, and I am not going to twist my tongue trying to give you all the names. We've got the Samsung Galaxy Tab Pro 8.4, and then we've got the Samsung Galaxy Note Pro 12.2. Aside from other tablets, man, these names are just crazy, but the tablets actually aren't. We have been testing these on the show floor, and they've behaved actually very well for what they are. We've got a lot of variants of these tablets as well, so we can expect these tablets in the US market very soon. Now, one of the reasons why these tablets are cool really deserve a separate segment. Samsung has completely revamped the whole TouchWiz UI, up to the point where we're actually liking what they've done. They're taking advantage of the full real estate of the display and doing more than just multi-window support. We've got floating windows, we've got different ambiences. It is a really smart UI that we like, and the reason why it deserves its full segment is because we've got new rumors that this is coming to the smartphone lineup as well. So I do believe this is something we can expect the Samsung Galaxy S5. Stay tuned, we did really like it. Links in the description for the full videos. Now, a company that hasn't made any headlines at CES, but that will very soon, is Motorola, as the company has just sent out press invitations for an event to happen on January 14th in Europe. And according to the teaser, what they're saying is that because of the success of the Moto G, they want to build on that. So we are expecting for the Moto X and some sort of variant to launch in the European market and hopefully bring the whole motormaker thing and everything. So stay tuned for that. That should happen very soon, though we are hoping for another phone. I mean, why not? And finally, for the hot news of the day, Pebble has just launched their new Pebble Steel. This is pretty much the company that's made wearables popular ever since the beginning of last year, and they use CES again to launch their new product. And I'll be honest with you, this design does not look geeky. It looks very, very elegant. It'll be retailing on January 28th for $250, which is kind of steep. But anyways, that leads me to the question of the day. What would you pay for this watch? I mean, do you think the $250 is good for this new Pebble Steel? In my particular case, honestly, I do like my Pebble. I don't feel that it's too geeky, but I would like something like the Steel up to the point where I'm willing to buy it for that price. I would pay for the extra elegance plus the added benefits. I do find $250 to be fair, but leave us a comment down below. What do you think about the price? And friends, you know the drill. If you want to get the news earlier before this video is filmed, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you tomorrow, and sorry for all the background noise. It's pouring rain here.